Hello. Today we're going to be talking about the third category in how to make ED, which would be accessory hoarding. This is going to be a little bit more interesting than the first two videos that I've done because this will be the first time I'll have to mention IBs or ice burners. Ice burners are a mechanic that allow users to spend real money on the game so that they can roll for in-game items such as costume weapons, accessories, and other items at a pretty low to pretty high chance depending on what you're trying to roll for. We will not be talking about IB accessories in this video. Those will be saved for another time. We will only be talking about the accessories that you can gain with in-game dungeons or in-game boxes and loot and things of that nature. Now, the first accessories that we'll be talking about are the first accessories that you get in the game, which would be the normal dungeon accessories. So, in Rune, you'll be running the first three dungeons, and you will notice that certain items are going to be in the window of the boss drop availability, and some of those items will be things you can accessorize on your character, like the monkey's tail. From there, you can take the monkey's tail and the other two items and see where they interplay with the game in general, as in you can put them on and then they affect your stats, and from there you can deduce that there are more accessories in the game for more of the slots that you have on your character. After that, you'll be going to Elder, where there's an accessory shop owner where she sells you all of the beginning tier accessories. These are just cosmetic only. You can neither make any significant kind of profit whatsoever off of these items, and they're just there to teach you that these items are in the game. After that, as you progress through the game, you'll be finding more and more accessories, and if you check the board to see where these accessories will lie, and so as far as how they are valued in the game, the first accessory set that you will see, which by accessory set I mean accessories that you get from a certain boss or a certain categorical grouping, that they will interplay with each other and give you a set bonus. And that set bonus will give you whatever stats or whatever effects that the accessory set spells out for you. And then from there, we can see that there are some accessory sets that you get before this set, but the most significant accessory set that will make you gay, that will make you ED, is Volcanic Flame Entrance's dungeon, the Ignia set that you can get from that dungeon. That is the most significant accessory set in the game that you will probably encounter, assuming that you had not gotten any from the boxes or any of the other ways you can earn accessories that we'll be covering. The Ignis set it will always be highly priced because of its raw damage, its effect on combat power, and how it is one of the easier accessory sets to obtain, but it is also still highly coveted, so it's always in circulation. It is also an elite tier accessory, which means you can seal it more than one time, unlike the unique tier accessories, or the accessories you can trade infinitely. So, after you get that accessory, you'll be encountering other accessory sets, either in Lanix, or after that, Elysian, and then after that, Elrianode. The next significant accessory set you'll be encountering is the Corrupted Elrianode set, which is comprised of the circlet, the headpiece, the bracelet, the earrings, the mask, and finally the weapon guard. From there, you will take these pieces and put them on the board, and just like the Igneous set, they are highly coveted pieces for their ability to enhance your combat power, and specifically for the earrings and the weapon guard, fill in slots that are quite uncommon for you to see anywhere else. Getting earrings were added not too long ago in the game's lifetime, and weapon accessories have been kind of hit or miss in how significant they are to get on your character, with the most useful of these being the Ereda weapon accessory. And all of these accessories can be gotten in the dungeon pre-sealed, so you can immediately toss them on the board and not really have to worry about resealing. But if you open the seal on them, then you would have to reseal them if you were using them and then you decided that you got a better accessory and you would like to seal them. You would need a purple for the elite and a gold seal for the unique pieces. After that, we'll be going to the Gate of Darkness. You will be encountering the Gate of Darkness at around Feta, and you go in and you fight waves of enemies that are guarding the wall that is the Gate of Darkness. And once you defeat it, you'll be getting three items, one of which you can use to save up and then trade at the accessory shop owner for a chance at getting either elite or unique Gate of Darkness accessories. This accessory set is something that a lot of people don't talk about because it's not in-game min-max material, but it is something to supplement your ED gain if you are just lacking in some regard. It's just free accessories that you can put on the board for not much effort other than getting bonus EXP and the other benefits that you do get when you do a Gate of Darkness. So it is essentially just a free way to rack up points and spend ED whenever you need it in the cash. The next point after that, we'll be talking about Ereda and the Ereda accessories. These are some of the most coveted accessories in the game due to their set effect and raw buffs and damage modifiers. So these are going to be some of the most pricey and expensive accessories in the game currently, and they also offer a huge boost to your combat power. However, they also come with the caveat of being one of the hardest and most difficult accessories and accessory sets to grind for because of how Ereda is in the current meta insofar as trying to queue and get the items you need to upgrade the Ereda accessory set, because you get them in two stages. They come in the Warriors variety, and then after that you can upgrade them to the Tenacious Warriors, or the, for the rings, Strong, Flexible, Tenacious Warrior variety of the upgraded set, which are some of the most valuable accessories in the game, specifically the upgraded Elrianode accessories. And by extension, having an entire set of these would net you a lot of money if you were to find someone looking for an entire set for a specific character or something like that. So that is one of the big, but albeit large investment accessory sets you could possibly hope to go for. Next, we'll be talking about the Dimension Master set, quite possibly the most powerful and therefore most expensive set of accessories that you can get in the game. They do have their own set effect, as well as being incredibly powerful accessory pieces on their own. Grinding for them is going to take about 2 weeks of daily consistent grind in the Sinister Intent dungeon. that you can enter 3 times per day. So in 14 days, you will have enough relics in order to trade for either a random chance, or by that time, you should also have 1 or 2 books. And from there, you will need a gold seal once you get it out of the box and open it on a specific character. I should also mention that these Dimension Masters pieces are character specific, so whatever character you open them on, they're going to be beholden to being able to be sold to only those the character that you opened it on. So if you wanted to get a Dimension Master's Eye, which is the support unit, to be sold for Eve, because no one else is selling it at the moment, you would have to have an Eve, open it on her, and then have it sealed, or I guess in the new seal system, have a gold seal in your inventory, and then put it on the board that way. After that, we have the accessories that come in boxes. Similar to the normal type of accessories you get when you just simply run dungeons, you'll be encountering these boxes. The Beginner Adventurer Cube, the Intermediate Adventurer Cube, and the Advanced Adventurer Cube, all of which hold a random chance to grab accessories from them. The Beginner Adventurer Cube has the accessories Mana Intensification Necklace, Spirit Overload Necklace, Berserker's Ring, Agile Ring, Solid Stone Ring, Acceleration Ring, and the Mana Concentration Necklace. Also, the Stamina Fortifier Necklace. Out of these items, I would say that the Acceleration Ring, the Agile Ring, and the Spirit Overload Necklace are probably the most coveted of these. But really, the Beginner Adventurer Cube accessories are just supplementary ED. Unless you find out that on the board, you can sell it for a little bit more than what it's worth. Things start to get a little bit more interesting with the Intermediate Adventurer Cube when you have the Necklace of Extreme Magic, the Necklace of Extreme Physical Strength, and all of the Elemental Rings that give you 100 plus whatever the element that it is, and a proc chance on that same element. These 3 types of accessories that you can get from the Intermediates are worth quite a bit more, but not at the same tier as what we're going to get into with the Advanced Adventurer Cubes, which are the Ring of Brilliant Attack, the Ring of Brilliant Protection, and the 3 types of Velder Kingdoms necklaces. These necklaces are some of the most coveted necklaces in the game, outside of the Ereda necklace, and specifically the Velder Kingdoms necklace of Victory and Destruction is going to be the one that you are going to be the most sought after, because it is the one that gives you the most CP, therefore it is the most valuable. And after that, you will have the Strength and Wisdom necklace, which is not too far behind. And then in last place, you have the Endurance Protector necklace, which only gives you defense, which people generally aren't really looking for. And then after that, you have Event Accessories. Event accessories generally come in 2 types, permanent and tradable, and we're basically only going to be talking about the permanent accessories that you can get, permanent and tradable accessories. So sometimes, such as in the now defunct Butler event that we just had not so long ago, you can grind out the event dungeon so that you can get event accessories, such as the glasses and the entire event set. So usually in these event trade situations, they would be of a normal tier type, which means you have to use a white accessory or a white seal in order to trade with them. And sometimes you don't have to use a seal at all, but usually you would need a white seal, which is the cheapest of all the 3 seals that we have currently, or the 4 seals. And sometimes these event accessories can be worth more than even the most coveted Ereda accessories and things like that, because of certain bonuses or just aesthetics that they can give off. Just having the premium factor of it no longer being an item you can get in the game. So always take that into consideration when doing your research about event accessories, and just always be aware of what's going on the board. If you have certain accessories that you think will be worth more in the long run, even long after the event is over. And with that, we're done talking about accessories. I hope that you have learned a lot about how to hoard your accessories and appraise them, and I hope you do well. Thank you for watching the video, and I'll see you later.